Myself, Dr. Asha Nervi, Professor and Head of the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, STM Medical College and Hospital, Dharwad.
Myself, Dr. Asha Rani, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, STM College of Medical Sciences and Hospital, Dharwad.
Together, we'll give you information on COVID-19 in pregnancy.
COVID-19, the global pandemic, has made everyone more worrisome with lot of anxiety and fear. If you are pregnant, undoubtedly you will have a lot of queries. Researchers have shown that the effects of COVID-19 in pregnancy is still in its infancy. Today I'll be talking about precautions for the pregnant women and healthcare workers, clinical presentations and complications, effects of COVID-19 on the mother and the fetus, approach to the diagnosis, and quarantine for the pregnant women in COVID-19 pandemic. If you are pregnant, what are the precautions you need to take? The same recommendations as per non-pregnant individuals. Wash your hands regularly and frequently, at least for 20 seconds with soap and water. You can also use sanitizers or alcohol-based hand rubs. You must wear masks. Keep a distance of at least 1 meter from the next person. Cover your mouth and nose with your bent elbow, handkerchief or tissue papers while you're coughing and sneezing. Avoid non-essential travels. Pregnant women with children should exercise caution. Avoid gatherings and functions. Working women can opt for work from home. And pregnant healthcare workers more than 36 weeks of gestation should stop face-to-face contact with the patients. What are the precautions to be taken for healthcare workers? Maintain a distance of at least 1 meter from the patients and other healthcare workers, and wherever the clinical examination is necessary, you should do under precautions. Remove your non-essential items from the consultation or examination room to reduce the risk of fomite spread. Regular hand washing at least for 20 seconds and use of appropriate PPEs. What are the clinical manifestations that the pregnant woman with COVID-19 infection presents to you? It is as similar to the non-pregnant individuals. She may present to you with fever, new onset of cough, shortness of breath, sore throat, myalgia, running nose or nasal congestion, altered smell and taste sensation, and also GI symptoms like diarrhea. The illness is classified as mild, severe and critical. Mild illness is where the pregnant woman will be asymptomatic or have mild symptoms like fever, fatigue and cough. Severe illness is tachypnea, that is respiratory rate more than 30 beats per minute, hypoxia where oxygen saturation is less than 93% of the room air, or more than 50% of lung involvement on imaging modality within 24 to 48 hours, and critical illness where the pregnant woman develops respiratory failure or in shock or multi-organ dysfunction. So what are the effects of COVID-19 on the mother? Pregnancy and childbirth do not increase the risk or worsen the clinical course of COVID-19 infection. Pregnant women with comorbidities like diabetes, obesity, asthma will have increased risk of developing severe disease. So pregnant women who develop COVID-19 complications like pneumonia has increased risk of preterm delivery and also higher rates for cesarean section. Pregnancy complications. If a pregnant woman has hyperthermia during first trimester, that is during organogenesis, it might be associated with increased risk of congenital anomalies, especially neural tube defects, and may she end up in miscarriages also. Acetaminophen, even during the first trimester, has shown to be overall safe and may attenuate the pregnancy risk associated with fever exposure. What are the effects of COVID-19 on fetus? There is emerging evidence now suggests that vertical transmission may be possible. So every neonate born to COVID-19 positive mother has to be screened for COVID-19. At present, there seems to be no clinically significant effects on the neonate even when it is tested positive. Testing in pregnancy should be done to all the symptomatic women with history of international travel in last 14 days, all symptomatic contacts of confirmed cases, all symptomatic healthcare workers, all pregnant women with severe acute respiratory illness or influenza-like illness with fever, cough and shortness of breath should be screened, and pregnant women residing in cluster or containment hotspot areas should be tested even if she is asymptomatic. This testing should not occur in obstetric OPDs and inpatient labor rooms and delivery unit. Pregnant women should be referred to the designated testing center if she is not in labor. A shielded chest x-ray can be done if needed, and some institution may advocate a pulmonary ultrasound for the rapid diagnosis of pneumonia in pregnant women. So what are the quarantine guidelines for the pregnant women? If a pregnant woman is tested positive or she is symptomatic, she should be isolated in the hospital facilities. If asymptomatic pregnant woman exposed to a suspected case, she may undertake the home quarantine for at least 14 days. If she becomes symptomatic at any point of time in these 14 days, she has to report to the hospital immediately. The guidelines for the home quarantine is she should stay in a well-ventilated single room, preferably with an attached toilet, needs to stay away from the elderly people, children or persons with comorbidities within the household and restrict the movements within the house, and under no circumstances she should attend any social gathering or functions like wedding and condolences.
Thank you, Asha, for that useful information. I will be giving information on antenatal care, intrapartum care, postpartum care, breastfeeding and contraception. My information is based on national guidelines recommended from Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, ICMR, and articles published till April 28, 2020. New guidelines are published every day and viewers are requested to update themselves. Visits should be optimized and timed. We should use telemedicine as MCI has given a green signal. Women should be informed to keep a count of fetal movements every day. Ultrasound visit should be scheduled and we should reduce waiting time of our pregnant woman. Routine ultrasound should be advised at 11 to 13 plus 6, that is called as NT scan. Anomaly scan should be done at around 18 to 19 plus 4 weeks, and definitely the last trimester we should do a growth scan. Coming to the assessment of pregnant woman who is not in labor but who is a suspected or confirmed case of COVID-19. Protocol based labor triage assessment is done. Recognize a critically ill woman, and this woman should be admitted in dedicated COVID hospital with ICU facility. Coming to the medical management and the drug used in COVID-19 infection, SCQ is used, azithromycin is used, and also antivirals are used. Along with this, we have to give supportive care to the pregnant woman. Plasma therapy is being assessed in trials. Paracetamol is safe if woman has fever. Antinatal steroids are recommended to enhance the lung maturity if preterm delivery is likely. Appropriate antibiotics are used whenever there is a secondary infection. Management of labor and delivery. COVID-19 infection is not an indication for induction of labor. Most infected mothers recover without undergoing delivery. Exception to this is critically ill woman, where we have to deliver her to relieve the extra metabolic and pulmonary load. Route of delivery should be as per the standard obstetric practice or as per the maternal condition. At present, pregnant women have almost universally delivered by cesarean section when they present in labor with COVID-19 infection. But there is no proven scientific rationale for this. A prolonged labor should be avoided as it is detrimental to the general condition of the woman. Healthcare should be mindful of adequate protective gear when they are caring for the laboring woman. It's very good news that COVID-19 infection is not detected in vaginal secretions or amniotic fluid, but the feces contain the virus and they spread the infection. So we have to be very careful. Regional anesthesia is safe whenever woman requires anesthesia, but when it comes to general anesthesia, we have to use specialized technique to protect the woman and the healthcare worker from aerosol transmission. Coming to the postnatal care and breastfeeding, if mother is asymptomatic, baby should be kept away from her at least more than 1 meter, but at the time of feeding, baby can come near to the mother. But mother has to wear an N95 mask and she has to practice all those hand hygiene, respiratory hygiene. And it is very fortunate that neonate, even if it infected, does not have any significant effect on its body. But if mother has cough, fever or dyspnea, and if baby is admitted in ICU, then we have to give her expressed milk. There is no evidence of transmission through the breast milk. It's very good news for us. Coming to the family planning and safe abortion services, as medical and surgical abortions are time sensitive, we have to continue them. Contraception to be provided to the eligible couple, and whenever we have to do surgical sterilization, it can be done, but it should be based upon available resources at your place.
Dear pregnant women, stay home, stay safe.
Be aware, be safe. Thank you.